Hello and welcome to my channel.
This is what we are going to create today. Let's see how to create this using After Effects. Before further proceeding, I would like to thank you for supporting me. If you are new to this channel, please do consider subscribing. That would be highly appreciated. Please don't skip the video. Please do watch the video completely. Let's not waste any more of the time. Let's get started.
Open up After Effects and create a new composition. Here I am choosing a 400 by 400 composition. With a frame rate of 30 and a duration of 10 seconds. I am naming this composition as Logo 1. Create your own logo, or else you can use your own PNG file. I am creating my own logo. Select the ellipse tool, set the fill to none and set the stroke to solid color. Set the stroke width to 40 and create a circle. Set the stroke color to white. Center align the circle. Now duplicate the shape layer 1 and reduce the stroke width to 15. Set the stroke color to black. Select the text tool and type in the text. Center align the text to the composition. Search for gradient ramp effect and apply it into the text layer. Choose any color of your choice. Copy the gradient ramp effect and apply it into the shape layer 1. Change the ramp center to create a proper gradient. Go to the project panel and duplicate the logo 1 layer. Open up the logo 2 layer. Change the color in the gradient ramp effect. Create a new composition. I am naming it as main. Set the width to 1920 and height to 1080. Set the frame rate to 30 and the duration to 10. Select the rectangle tool and create a random shape. And select the fill to solid color and set the stroke to none. Open up the shape layer 1. In the rectangle path, unlink the X and Y dimensions of the size property and set it to 50 and 50. Also set the roundness to 50. Press P to open up the position property. For better positioning, select title action safe and center align the shape layer 1. Move the shape layer 1 to the left side of the composition like this and create a keyframe at the start of the timeline. At 1 second mark, set the position of the shape layer 1 like this. Now select the two keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them, or else you can right click and click on keyframe assistant and click on easy ease. Open up the graph editor and change the graph as shown. At 1 second mark, split the shape layer 1 and delete the previous position keyframes. Open up the contents. In rectangular path 1, create a keyframe for size and roundness at 1 second mark. At 2 second mark, set the size value to 20,400. Set the roundness to 0. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open up the graph editor and change the graph as shown. At the 2 second mark, split the shape layer 2. Select the shape layer 3 and delete all the previous keyframes. At 2 second mark, create a keyframe for the position. And at the 3 second mark, increase the X value of the position like this. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open up graph editor and change the graph as shown. Split the shape layer 3 at the 3 second mark and select the shape layer 4 and delete all the previous keyframes. At 3 second mark, create a keyframe for position. And at the 4 second mark, set the position value as shown. Now select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open up graph editor and change the graph as shown. Split the shape layer 4 at 4 second mark and select the shape layer 5 and delete all the previous keyframes. Open up shape layer 5. In the rectangle path, create a keyframe for size at 4 second mark, go forward about 20 frames and set the size value to 20,20. Go forward about 5 seconds and set the size value to 30,30. Go forward about 5 seconds and set the size value to 20,20. Go forward about 5 seconds and set the value to 30,30. Once again, go forward about 5 seconds and set the value to 0,0. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Now split the shape layer 5 at 6 second mark and delete the shape layer 6. Now bring in the logo 1 and logo 2 composition into the main composition timeline. Create a new solid layer. Set the width and height to 400 and name it as Mat 1. Bring down the Mat 1 layer above the logo 1 layer and press S to bring up the scale property. Before that, go to the 2 second mark and trim the Mat 1 layer and increase the X value of the scale property to around 300. Press P to bring up the position property and set the position of the Mat 1 layer to something like this. Make sure the Mat 1 layer is snapped to the Shape 3 layer. Now parent the Mat 1 layer to the Shape 3 layer and set the track mat of the logo 1 layer to Alpha Mat Mat 1 layer. Now duplicate the Mat 1 layer, trim the duplicated layer to the 3 second mark. Press P to bring up the position property and move it to the right of Shape Layer 4. Now parent the duplicated layer to the Shape 4 layer and rename the duplicated layer to Mat 2. Bring down the Mat 2 layer above the Logo 2 layer and change the track mat of the Logo 2 layer to Alpha Mat Mat 2 layer. Now move up the Mat 2 and Logo 2 layer above the Mat 1 and Logo 1 layers. Search for Fill Effect from the Effects and Presets panel and apply it into the Shape 3 layer. Set the color to white. At 2 second mark, create a keyframe for color. Go forward about 10 seconds and set the color to the logo 1 layer color. Apply the fill effect to the shape layer 4 and change the color to the color of the logo 1 layer. At 3 second mark, create a keyframe for color. Go forward in time so that the logo 2 layer gets revealed, and at the time frame, change the color from logo 1 color to logo 2 color. Apply the fill effect to the shape layer 5 and change the color to logo 2 color. Click on the text tool and type in your text and move the text layer to the center bottom of the composition. Create a stroke using the rectangle tool like this and move it below the created text layer. I would like to reduce the height and width, so I am using the size properties. Now bring up the position property of the text and the shape layer 6 and move the position values as shown. At 2 second mark, create keyframes with this position values, and at 3 second mark, bring in the shape layer 6 and the text layer to the bottom center. Go to the 4 second mark and create keyframes with the same position values, and at 5 second mark, move the position values as shown. Now select all the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Apply the fill effect to the text layer and the shape layer 6 and change the fill color to white. Keyframe the color property at 2 second mark for the text layer and also the shape layer 6. Go forward about 15 frames and change the color to logo 1 color. Do this for the text layer also. Choose a point just before the logo 2 layer gets revealed and create keyframes with the same color values. Do this for the shape layer 6 also. Go forward in time about 10 seconds so that the logo 2 layer gets revealed and change the fill color to logo 2 color. Do this for the text layer also. our ramp preview this. That's it, we have created a smooth and simple logo reveal animation. Hope you enjoyed this video. Let's see the output once again. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post the videos. Click on the like button and share it with your friends. Comment down if you have anything to ask. And once again, thanks for being here and supporting me. This is Raudran signing off.